and made me whole. I will never cease to praise Him. I'll sing it while eternity holds.
Good morning. Welcome to 40 Days of Miracles. We're in the High Sierra this morning, the backcountry. We made it to the top of Judah Peak. We're reading through every miracle recorded in the four Gospels, the miracles of the Lord Jesus Christ. We come to Matthew chapter 8, verse 14. We come to the story of Jesus going to the home of Peter's mother-in-law. It's an incredible story. She's very sick. She has a high fever. And Jesus does something very special. He goes to her home. He goes to her room. He reaches out and he touches her by the hand. And she is instantly healed. Boy, aren't there some incredible lessons in this miracle story? Being in the ministry, one of the things that we take for granted and we overlook is our team and our staff. Peter had been walking with Jesus and, well, Jesus heals a stranger with leprosy and he heals a little boy that's paralyzed when a Roman official comes. But what about your staff? What about your team? What about people you know? Someone made it popular in a sermon, charity starts at home. Hey, how about that? How about miracles start at home? It's pretty easy to overlook our family and our friends. God not only gives us miracles to strangers, God starts in our own homes. And the first observation I have today is Jesus makes house calls. How's that? That's pretty cool. Jesus makes house calls. The second observation I've already mentioned, he starts with his team. He starts with men that have been walking with him. Don't overlook your family and your friends. We get passionate about outreach, going to the street ministry, people we never met before. My second observation is miracles happen in our own home with our family and friends. And the third observation is the way in which Jesus gently touches her hand. And the moment he touches her hand, she is healed. A beautiful part of this story that I just want to mention in passing is when you have a miracle in your life, boy, you just get right back up and you start serving again. She didn't lay around. She didn't take a vacation. She got right up and she prepared a meal for Jesus. What I like about this miracle story is she was serving the Lord right after the miracle. Has God given you a miracle? Has He? Has God blessed you with a miracle and you have a testimony? Are you serving Him today? Wow, this is a powerful lesson. Well, I love being in the backcountry and I've got a long way to go. There's a lot of snow and it's kind of dicey up here, pretty windy at this elevation. What a joy to worship the Lord in song and in the Word, and especially with you. Again, you remember, God loves you and so do we. You be blessed today and be safe. I'm going to be safe on the trail. You be safe.
As
blessings.
The mighty rushing wind blows through our hearts, let us be cleansed from every doubt and every fear. Let us deeply drink of the waters of your life, as the fragrance of your presence draws so near. Let the power of your strength be in us all. Let it rise inside our hearts and take command. us take our rightful place within this world. Let us learn not just to walk, but Jesus, teach us how to stand.